if you're 100, you have lived a very, very long time. And our centenarians know that. They know that they've lived an extraordinary amount of time, longer than most of them would have expected. The point that we need to make about age and time is that people need to accept and redefine what a certain age means, or define what it means personally to them, which may be quite different from others.
Family is important, isn't it?
Yeah, very, very important.
It's not a secret, you are 106 years old.
Yeah, just got that last birthday.
Yes. What is it like to be 106?
Well, I didn't think anyone was different from any other of these birthdays, but this morning when I got up and they said something about 106, I said, I certainly do feel that 106. But I still get up and walk around, and I think I'm pretty lucky to get up. I can't do the things that I would like to do. And you know, you aren't aware of just how weak you really are until you really think about it. Because I might be lying up in the bed, just waking up, and I think, I'll get up and take a good warm bath and I'll be all right. I can't get up and get in the tub. So that's different. I got to wait for somebody to put me up on this and wash me here. And it ain't no fun.
We cannot change age, chronological age. That will always be defined the way that it is defined now. But if it indeed it isn't age that affects our health or our mental health, if it is the way that we cope with life, the way that we deal with stressors, the supports that we have, if it is our personality, maybe we can change those aspects of our lives. And that's why it is so important to look at other aspects other than just age.